I am Richard Feldman, Chairman of the Department of Environmental Science and Policy at Marist College. I'm also the professor for a class called Natural History of the Hudson Valley. And I'm out here today with that class. We're near the North Gate entrance to campus, near the North End dorms. And behind me is what's called a swale. And the swale has a lot of flowering wildflowers. Today, I'm helping my students to learn how to identify flowering plants. So for the next period of time, you'll be witnessing the process that we go through to identify these plants. Let's do this together. Okay, so how many petals does this plant have on its flowers?
Four.
Okay, that's true. And how are the leaves arranged?
Opposites.
Show me opposite arrangement.
It's alternate.
It is alternate.
Okay.
I was looking at it from your angle.
Okay. So we have four parts of a flowering wildflower.
No, so right next to the common evening primrose, it has a daytime flower, and it shows that because if you go and read the common evening primrose, it says it's only fully open at twilight, and it's not twilight, it's the middle of the day. So they included a picture losing it, and then if you look at the flowers, it matches.
Awesome.
It is awesome, right?
Yeah.
We did it.
Yep.
Okay. All right. Good team effort. So let's join the rest of the class by the stop sign and see what they're focusing on, okay? Hey, gang.
Hello.
For my purposes, I refer to my Petersons as my botanical Bible. It's a way to reference back to the ones that I saw. So let me hear how you came to your decision about your species identification on this.
So I think your argument is that the mild water pepper is a little more sparse and like broken in the flowers. And the
so the inflorescence is not broken. One continuous,
yeah.
Yes, it's a broken spike, excuse me. This is a very good example right here. Continuous inflorescence. There is some breaking on this one, but you need to look at multiple examples. There's very few hairs coming out from the sheath. By comparison, John, is that specimen still around? It's in the genus Polygonum, right? Or is it calling it something else? Is it Polygonum?
Yeah.
All right. I think we've sat enough in one spot. Should we look around for some more? And what's the three-digit code that you came up with?
What was it? I forget.
It was 6632.
So six parts. It's
yes.
Symmetrical. Six flower parts.
And we said it was opposite.
Opposite leaves,
yeah.
So that's the
four.
Three. That's four.
Yeah.
You confirmed it in Petersons.
I was about to do that.
Okay. Always good to use
right
the second
one. We just found that,
yeah.
And we were.
And I was about to look through the purple.
Good. So confirm it with Peterson.
Yep.
How you two doing?
Good job.
Yeah, it's good. Good. Good.